Okay, so continuing with our previous lecture, verify whether the following are zeros of polynomial, indicate against them. Now, I will teach you how to find zeros of polynomial. Okay, so if your answer comes is equals to zero, if your answer comes zero, then it is a zero of a polynomial. If it is not coming zero, then it is not a zero of a polynomial. So, starting with our first term, first is 3x plus 1. It is given that p of x is equals to 3x plus 1 and x value is given as minus 1 by 3. So, what we will do, we will substitute p of minus 1 by 3. So 3 into minus 1 by 3 plus 1, 3, 3 gets cancelled. Minus 1 plus 1, answer is 0. Then yes, it is a 0 of a polynomial. Pay attention, likhne ki koi guide mat karo, aap logo ko YouTube pe mil jayega. Okay, pay attention over here only. Then your second sum, usi mein, P of x is equals to 5x minus 5 and x value is given as 4 by 5. Okay, so p of 4 by 5 is equals to 5x minus 5, or you can say 5 into 4 by 5. 5 5 gets cancelled. 4 minus 5. Is your answer coming 0? No, then it is not a 0 of a polynomial. Moving ahead, sum number third, px or p of x is equals to x square minus 1. Well, you have to find two values, one p of 1 and another is p of minus 1. If p of 1, then 1 ka square will be 1, minus 1, answer 0. That means p of 1 is a 0 of a polynomial. And p of minus 1 ka square hota hai, 1 minus 1, and that is again 0. So both are what? The zeros of your polynomial. Right? Then there are a few more terms. Don't speak in between, Nupur. Useless girl. Okay. So sum number 4. P of x is equals to x plus 1 and x minus 2. Okay. X plus 1 and x minus 2. You have to find P of minus 1 and P of 2. P of minus 1, minus 1 plus 1, minus 1 minus 2. Minus 1 plus 1 will be your 0 into minus 3. Anything into 0 is what? It is 0. So yes, it is your polynomial, 0 of a polynomial. What about 2? So 2 plus 1, 2 minus 2. So 2 plus 1 is 3, but 2 minus 2 is 0. Answer again 0, then yes, it is again your 0 of a polynomial. Then, sum number 5th. P of x is equals to x square. And what is given? X is equals to 0 given already. So, obviously, what will be your answer? Yes, it is a 0 of a polynomial. So, P of 0 is equals to 0 square and answer is 0. Right? Then comes sum number 6, p of x is equals to lx plus m and x given as minus m upon l.
Sir, aapka bahut blur dikh raha hai.
Don't speak in between. So p of minus m by l, then l into minus m by l plus m, l gets cancelled, minus m plus m, so it is 0, then yes, it is also your 0 of a polynomial. Then your next sum is 7th sum. Here it is given that p of x is equals to 3x square minus 1. And x value is given two ways. X is minus 1 by 3 as well, and x is minus 1 by root 3, and x is equals to 2 by root 3. Now I am removing this. First to solve another one. So p of x is equals to 3x squared minus 1. Now keeping x as minus 1 by root 3. So minus 1 by root 3 can be written as 3 into minus 1 by root 3 whole square minus 1. 3 will remain as it is. Minus 1 ka square kya hoga? 1. Or root 3 ka square hoga? 3 minus 1. 1 minus 1, answer 0. Yes, it is a 0 of a polynomial. And another is p of 2 by root 3. So instead of x, we will use 2 by root 3. So 3 into 2 by root 3 whole square minus 1. 3 into 2 ka square 4, root 3 ka square 3 minus 1. 3, 3 cancel, 4 minus 1, answer 3. So this is not a 0 of a polynomial. Answer hamesha 0 aayega, to hi wo 0 of a polynomial kahenge. Theek hai? Next, one more sum of this type.
Sir.
One more sum of this type.
Hello, sir.
And that is p of x is equals to 2x plus 1, right? And x is given as half. So p of half will be 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1. 2 gets cancelled. 1 plus 1, answer 2. So it is not a 0 of a polynomial, right? यहां तक सबको समझ में आया होगा. Now the next question is, zero of a polynomial in each of the following case is what you have to find out. When you have to do this, then what we will have to do, straight away compare it with zero. The sums are like this. There are, I guess, 7 sums. And sums are there. First, p of x is equals to x plus 5. Now what we will have to do, we are comparing this polynomial or this equation straight away with 0. So x plus 5 is equals to 0. So when this term will go right like this on right hand side, 0 minus 5, answer will be your minus 5, right? Then second, p of x is equals to x minus 5. P of x is equals to x minus 5. Again, x minus 5 is equals to 0. So x is equals to 0 plus 5. Answer 5. So number third, p of x is equals to 3x minus 2. So now what we will do? Px minus 2 is equals to 0. 3x is equals to, now I am writing straight away, 0 plus 2 will be 2. Now this is in multiplication. When this multiplication will go on this side, it will become what? Your division. So 2 by 3. Right?
Then, sir. Sir.
Just a moment. Next is Px is equals to 2x plus 5. P of x is equals to 2x plus 5. So 2x plus 5 is equals to 0. 2x will be equals to minus 5, and x is equals to minus 5 upon 2. Right? Then next is p of x is equals to 3x. Now what you will do? P of x is equals to 0, x is equals to 0 upon 3, and x is equals to 0. Right? Then next, p of x is equals to a of x, means a into x. Again, same answer will come. Ax is equals to 0, x is equals to 0 upon a, answer is 0. Right? Then next, p of x, the last sum of the day, is equals to cx plus d. Now, cx plus d is equals to 0. Cx is equals to 0 minus d, that is nothing but your minus d, and x will be minus d upon c. Okay, so that's the end of our exercise 2.2. Now,